Welcome you all. Myself, I am Dr. Satyayan Dornala, presently working as Panchkarma specialist at Swami Vivekananda Ayurvedic Panchkarma Hospital, Delhi, Bharat. I am going to discuss about the topic Principles and Practice of Ayurvedic Therapeutics. You know, Ayurveda has a history of 5000 years. Still, the concepts and the principles which were discussed in Ayurveda are still relevant in the contemporary times. That's how the foundation of Ayurveda is being thought of during those good olden days. What exactly, there are different contexts where different principles are discussed at different therapeutics of different diseases. So we take different aspects as a whole, how these are the guiding principles in day-to-day management of the different diseases. We look at the word chikitsa and therapeutics both ways. Looking at therapeutic from chikitsa aspect, looking at chikitsa from therapeutic aspects. You know, the word chikitsa means it is pravruttir dhatu samyardham. The action we take under the heading of chikitsa is, it is to bring back the balance of bodily doshas. That's why in contemporary we call as homeostasis of doshas. Pravruttir dhatu samyardha chikitsa, and in turn doshas and dhatus, as we consider the samprapti as the dosha dosha sammurchana. And another aspect we may consider as a vikara prashamanam chikitsa. So vikara means which is derailment of a normal physiology, that is we consider as a vikara, and vikara prashamanam, that is mitigation of vikara, is ultimate aim of chikitsa. And the word which mostly simulates with chikitsa is the therapeutics in contemporary science. It is the treatment and care of the patient for the purpose of both preventing and combating the disease or alleviating pain or injury. The term comes from the Greek therapeutikos, which means inclined to serve. Ayurveda beautifully said, it is that the very purpose of chikitsa is, there are two goal strategy, that is swasthyasya urjaskaram arthasya roganat. The word swasthyasya urjaskaram means preservation of health of a healthy individual, that we consider as a wellness in a broader sense, and arthasya roganat is cure of the disease birth, that is illness. Always Ayurveda emphasizes that the approach is from wellness to illness, rather the contemporary science, the approach is from illness to wellness. Before going to the purpose of chikitsa is to serve the diseased person, to bring back his derailed doshas to homeostasis. But before a person is declared as a rogi, the diseased person, before that he will be in a swasthya, that is healthy person. And the description of swasthya, that is healthy person, in Ayurveda is in its broad sense. That is samadosha, samagnicha, samadhatu, malakriya, prasannatmendriya mana swastheta bhiti. And we tend to correlate this word swasthya is as a healthy in the contemporarily. And this particular Sanskrit verse means one whose physiological functions, doshas, metabolism, that is agni, bodily tissues, dhatus, and excretory function, malas, are in a state of dynamic equilibrium, with cheerful mind, clarity of intellect and contented sense is said to be established in oneself. That the word swasthya is swasthya. Sthya is establishment, the swa means self. And always it is in a dynamic equilibrium rather than static equilibrium. Because the health, status of health differs from person to person. If you look at this, the definition of health by World Health Organization, that health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being, and not merely the absence of the disease or infirmity. As a whole, in Ayurveda, swastha is sum of dynamic balance of dosha, dhatu, mala, agni, soul, senses and mind. So the dynamics of health in Ayurveda is in broader sense. So it's not only the physical at level, it's only the mental level, it is psychological level and emotional level and sociological level and many more. And if you look at this word healthy, this how beautifully this word implies, rather taking as an Ayurveda further definition, that is swasthya, and the WHO definition as health, and if you try to find the people taking this definition in the society, it will become very difficult to categorize somebody under this heading. So that's how it made me, an idea came to my mind that how can a person to be declared as an healthy. So as I was looking at this word healthy, it is, the word is with two syllables, that heal plus thai. And poetically the word thai means self, heal means healing capacity. So my perception of healthy is, as long as a person has self-healing capacity on his own, then he will be declared, he will be considered as a healthy person. Healthy doesn't mean that you will get affected with the disease. Of course, you will be get afflicted with the disease like a seasonal affective disorders. Still, you will be get rid of kind of affliction, seasonal afflictions within a maximum of 7 to 10 days. As the natural course of the seasonal afflictions goes down. So similarly, so considering the same, so healthy is as long as a person has a self-healing capacity on his, in him or her, so he'll be considered as a healthy person. Moving further, though the Ayurveda has a history of 5000 years, still in the previous slides, the fundamentals and the concepts which are still relevant in the current times. So if you look at this, there are different specialities that are described detailed in Ayurveda. There are ashtangas, there are clinical specialities, and accordingly, and in addition to that, there is also non-clinical specialities are detailed. So these clinical specialty, particularly there are 8 specialities which is discussed under the heading of Ashtanga Ayurveda. That is Kaya Chikitsa, Bala Chikitsa, Bhuta Chikitsa, Shalakya Chikitsa, Shalya Chikitsa, Gadha Chikitsa, Jara Chikitsa and Vrsha Chikitsa. And the beauty of this is, though there is a Jara Chikitsa which is mainly dealt with the disease of the aged people, though this field is probably maybe a decade or 2 decades, it's upcoming in the contemporary science, but the same thing is discussed and detailed almost along very good old days in Ayurveda, considering the importance. That's what the foresight of acharyas, they find the identified this importance of this particular specialty and the field. And additionally, we do have in a non-clinical specialties, that is Vishatantra toxicology and pharmacology and pathology and many more. Moving further, coming to the therapeutic principles. Maybe you come across, there are other principles. These principles are mentioned with respect to the therapeutics. There are other principles which are also there in the discussed in Ayurveda. So what I felt that, and in my day-to-day practice, so we put these therapeutic principles in the back end of the mind, and so that's how we move ahead for the taking the further guidelines. So therapeutic actions. So what exactly these therapeutic principles helpful in the day-to-day clinical practice, particularly in Ayurvedic clinical practice? And the Trisutra, Ninnadana Trayam, Nidana Panchakam, Shatkriya Kala, Agni and Ama, Trivida Chikitsa, Srotomayam Purushaha, Sneha Saroyam Purushaha. Trisutra. The word Trisutra means, in Sanskrit word, 3 means 3 and Sutra are the principles. It is a principle trade of disease management. And Acharya Charaka, it is said that Hetulinga Ushadajnanam Swasti Atra Parayanam. These three aspects has to be understood both in the case of healthy person and the diseased person. Not only in the person, in the same person, when he is in a healthy condition, he is become a diseased, and what are those things. So the point is, for example, Hetu is the causes, and the cause of health and disease. So the both the things has to be. So this is what the entire epidemiology and public health aspect is, the field is dealt usually. What exactly the causation effect, cause and effect relation between disease and the way the people live. And then coming to the linga, that is symptoms, symptoms of health and the symptoms of disease. And the people living in the different geographical locations. So the symptoms of health may be to some extent vary from different people. That is the, in Ayurveda we call it the desha. So desha also influences the health of the individual. And the aushadha, that is the medicines for the promotion and maintenance of health and the elimination of the disease. So these three aspects has to be considered while going to manage any particular condition, particularly in the chronic disease. So those things has to be, for example, in a client and then a patient came to you having an history of 10 years. So while taking the detailed history of the disease, maybe you will go to before the disease, when for example you said the disease started in 2000 year. So you may take the history before the 2000, how he was and how the things were led to the how to get the particular in the disease. So that's how, so this Hetu, Linga and Aushadha Trisutra plays a major role in handling in a day-to-day cases. Nidana Trayam, that is causation triad. Ayurveda is very systematically and broadly categorized almost all the causative factors into three headings. That is Asatmendriya are the Samyoga, Prajnaparada and Parinama, that is Kala. The word Asatmendriya Ardha Samyoga means Asat, Indriya and Ardha and Samyoga. Indriyas means we all know there are Ekadashi Indriyas and as a whole in simple we make it as sense organs and Jnani Indriyas, Karmi Indriyas and Ubeyendriya, that is Manas. Incompatible correlation of the sense organs with their object. For example, so Indriya is in eyes are the Indriyas and Indriya are the for respective for eyes are the vision. So you are supposed to have, if you look at the something sunlight, sun continuously for an half an hour, so naturally it affects your vision. So that's how it is something which is misunion of the Indriya, that is eyes and its Indriya are the vision. So that's how it's incompatible correlation of sense organs with their objects. Coming to the Prajnaparada, that willful indulgence in unhealthy practices that leads to imbalanced body functions and the disease. So maybe main number of examples, that is Vega Dharana and Viruddha Harvihar. Parinama and Kala, that is time and season. So as we all know, that is definitely there is an influence of the seasons on the individuals. That's what there is in a separate category of the disease, which usually discussed in the contemporary of the seasonal affective disorders. So considering as a whole, in turn these three maybe and further to be considered as an Atiyoga, Ayoga and Vidyayoga. Atiyoga means which is in excess, that is hyper use. Atiyoga is hypo use, Vidyayoga is unnatural use. So that's how, and among these three, Nidana Traya, causation triad, and Prajnaparava is ultimate the major one which is further influenced other two aspects. For example, if the individual having the Prajnaparada, so naturally is more inclined to do the mistakes in the seasons which is not supposed to be done, and again the same in the Asatmendriya Sabyoga also. That's how the Nidana Trayam is has an impact, direct influence in the management strategy. So this, just if you look at this as a pictorial, there is a similar kind of a triad of disease causation is discussed in the homeopathy, that is exciting cause, fundamental cause and maintaining cause. If I am trying to look at this from this causation triad, so as I said, Prajnaparada is the fundamental cause and exciting cause is Asatmendriya or the Samyoga, and maintaining cause is the Parinama. Coming to the Nidana Panchaka. Nidana Panchaka is the tool for the diagnosis. It is the tool for the diagnosis, how these five aspects has to be considered while coming to the diagnosis and further the management of the disease. So Nidana Panchaka is, there are five steps, that is Nidana, Pururupa, Rupa, Upashaya, Samprapti and Samprapti. Nidana is, as you know, that is a causation of the disease. Pura Rupa is the preclinical symptoms. Rupa is the symptomatology. Upasheya is exploratory diagnosis. Samprapti is the pathogenesis, that is dosha dosha sammurchana. These five steps also need to be considered. That's how the disease is further explored in a better way. Thereby, we can give in a better management. Samprapti Ghatak. So, after the Nidana Panchak, we analyze the Samprapti Ghatak, that is dosha, dusha, which dosha is the dominant dosha. Of course, there are conditions where we find all the three doshas are involved, but naturally we see which dosha is the dominant at the time when the patient visited you. So, and the dusha, of course, and the Agni and Ama and Srotas, Sroto, Dushti, Roga Udbhavasthana, Roga Vyaktasthana. So that's again the important roga marga, that is again the sadhya sadhya, the prognosis of the disease. These aspects also have to be considered. So until unless you don't find out the sadhya sadhyata, so it has to be given the proper information to the client. So sadhya sadhya is to also be to be assessed properly. Shatkriya kala. So this particular Shatkriya, this unique to Ayurveda, this gives the stage of the disease as per the Ayurveda. So there are different stages of the disease in the modern science. So this is also gives the stage of the disease, and Sanchaya, Prakopa, Prasara, Sthana Samshreya, that is, and Vyaktavastha and Bedavastha. Usually Ayurveda says preclinical symptom usually we see in the Sthana Samshreya stage. So if you could target the disease or the at Pura Rupa stage, so definitely the disease can be reversed. So these are the Shatkriya Kalas. So this is an example of taking in one clinical condition, that is Arbuda, how Arbuda Shatkriya Kalas are there. So the Nidana, as I said, it's Midyar, we are exposed to carcinogens and taking incompatible foods. That is the Nidana. That usually chronic exposure to the different carcinogens leads to the initiation of the carcinogens, that is Sanchaya of Tridoshas, which in turn further causes the Prakopa, that is hyperplasia we consider, and it is causes the one cell is initially involved, and this particular mechanism is shifted to the adjacent cell, that is called metaplasia, that is Prasara of Tridoshas, and later it is Sthana Samshreya, that is the development of the new tissue, that is neoplasia we call as a benign tissue, that is a benign tumor. And in turn, it will be Vyaktavastha, that is, it's a clear cut the disease development and established as a disease, that is the carcinoma in situ. And Bedavastha, this particular disease gets differentiated, further multiplied and leads to the metastasis, and again it is metastasis due to angiogenic factors. So this is how this Shatkriya color are beautifully is given in the clinical condition of the Arbuda.